लेसन नंबर 7 रॉक्स एंड रॉक्स टाइप्स. नाउ इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक स्टूडेंट्स वन पिक्चर इज बीन गिवन दैट इज डू इट योर सेल्फ. ऑब्जर्व द पिक्चर इन फिगर 7.1 एंड आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू ऑल द 3 पिक्चर्स. नाउ इन दिस पिक्चर ए इट इज अ लैंडस्लाइड. लैंडस्लाइड मीन्स वॉट? इट इज अ मूवमेंट ऑफ रॉक्स और सॉइल स्लोपिंग डाउन ड्यू टू रेन एंड द अदर फैक्टर्स दैट लीड्स टू लैंडस्लाइड. लैंडस्लाइड इज अ नेचुरल क्लैमिटी. नाउ कैन यू सी द पिक्चर बी? इट इज अ माइनिंग. नाउ हियर सम वर्किंग प्रोसेस इज बीइंग गोइंग ऑन. सम मैन्स आर हियर ऑन द हियर लिटिल बिट माउंटेन साइड टू ऑब्टेन द वैल्यूएबल स्टोन और रॉक्स. इट इज नोन एज माइनिंग. सी सी पेबल्स. दिस आर नोन एज सी रॉक्स पेबल्स. यू माइट हैव सीन इट इन फिश टैंक्स और डेकोरेशन ऑफ होम पेबल्स इन वेरियस स्ट्रक्चर साइज एंड कलर्स. नाउ कैन यू टेल द सिमिलरिटी अबाउट ऑल द 3 पिक्चर्स? द सिमिलरिटी इज द रॉक एंड द डिफरेंस इज इन ए पिक्चर इट इज अ नेचुरल क्लैमिटी ऑफ रॉक्स. बी मैन मेड एक्टिविटी कटिंग ऑफ रॉक्स. एंड सी नेचुरल प्रोसेस रॉक्स आर फॉर्म. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दिस वी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द आंसर्स. नाउ इन ए पिक्चर वॉट इज द हिल इन ए मेड अप ऑफ? ऑब्वियसली बिग रॉक्स. वॉट इज बीन डन इन बी? द रॉक्स आर एक्सट्रैक्टेड and are loaded onto the truck by using the machine. Can you see in this picture? What do we see in C? We can see stones of small size. Is there any relationship between the 3 things shown above? Yes, there is a relationship between the 3 things shown above. By using machines, the rocks are extracted from the hills and the rocks are further split into the stones. For what purpose do we use these things shown in A and C? The things are used for constructing monuments and buildings, extracting minerals, sculpturing, etc. Now explanation. We have seen last year that the earth's crust is hard. It is made up of rock and soil. Obviously, it is made up of rock and soil. Rocks are found on land surface and also below it. Rocks are a mixture of different minerals formed by natural processes in this lithosphere. The properties of rocks depend on the constituent minerals and their proportion as well as on the formation process, like silica, aluminium, magnesium and iron are the major rock forming minerals. Therefore, are other minerals too in different rocks. Now, types of rocks. There are 3 types of rocks according to their formation. Which are they? Igneous rocks, it is also called as primary rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Now, first we will see the igneous rocks. Now here, when the molten material here this side, when the molten material known as magma within the crust and lava, this is a within the crust and this is a lava on the surface, can you see here on the surface when it gets cools down, it solidifies giving rise to rocks. Can you see this? These are the rocks. These are known as igneous rocks. As these rocks are found out of material from the interior of the earth, all these rocks are found within the interior of the earth. These are also referred as primary. Mostly these rocks appear hard and homogeneous. These are heavy as well as we do not get fossils in these rocks. Now what do you mean by fossils? The remain or impression of a prehistoric plant or animal embedded in rocks and preserved in petrified form. This is known as fossils. The Maharashtra Plateau and the Sahyadris are found out of igneous rocks. Basalt is a major example of igneous rocks. So this is a basalt rock. It is an example of igneous rocks. Most of the hill forts in Maharashtra have lakes or elephant yards. Actually, these are old quarry sites. Can you see here? These are known as the quarry sites. Rocks was excavated from these sites and used for the construction of fort and the other buildings. So all these were used for the construction of forts and building purpose. In the pits and dugouts left behind after rock extractions, water was allowed to accumulate and these lake tanks were created. Can you see in the textbook picture 7.3, the reservoir on a fort. Now sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks. Due to continuous variation in temperature, rocks develop cracks. Similarly, the water percolating through rocks dissolves the soluble minerals. This leads to weathering of rocks. They get disintegrated or decomposed. Can you see here? Disintegrated or decomposed. That is, they get reduced to pieces. These rocks particles get transported by rivers, glaciers, wind, etc. towards the low-lying area and are deposited there. One after the other, can you see one after the other here? The layers of sediments get deposited in this way. These are the layers. The upper layer exert heavy pressure on the low layer. Can you see? The upper layer get heavy pressure on the lower layers. This led to compaction of material. Can you see here? This led to compaction of material and development of sedimentary rocks. So how the sedimentary rocks are formed? I have explained you with this picture.